Hello, Landry Hat readers. I'm Jennifer Martin, and you're watching The Landry Hat Show. TheLandryHat.com is your source for everything Dallas Cowboys. Speaking of the Cowboys, they finished week two of the NFL season on a somber note. The boys were crushed on Sunday in a blowout loss to the Seattle Seahawks, 27-7. The Hawks took advantage of Dallas's early mistakes to grab hold of the lead, and they never let go. The loss drops Dallas to 1-1 in the season. They're now tied for second place in the NFC East with the Washington Redskins and the New York Giants. The Philadelphia Eagles sit atop the division at 2-0. The Cowboys will face the 1-1 Tampa Bay Buccaneers in their home opener at Cowboys Stadium on Sunday. Dallas is 6-4 in their last 10 home openers. Now, the Bucs are coming off a heartbreaking loss to the New York Giants over the weekend. They defeated the up-and-coming Carolina Panthers and Cam Newton in Week 1. It was the Bucs' first win since October 16, 2011. In their last matchup, Dallas defeated Tampa Bay at home 31-15. Dallas quarterback Tony Romo had 4 touchdowns in last season's win. But the Cowboys will be facing a very different group than the 4-12 Bucs team they beat last year. Also, Tampa Bay has a new head coach in Greg Schiano, and the former Rutgers University coach has some new toys to play with. The Bucs acquired wideout Vincent Jackson, guard Carl Nix, tight end Dallas Clark, and cornerback Eric Wright through free agency this offseason. And they drafted running back Doug Martin in the first round of this year's NFL draft. Coach Schiano has also brought in a tougher mentality to the team, which was evident by their unwillingness to give in the final moments of this weekend's Giants game. On the other side of the ball, the Cowboys have defeated the Bucs the last 3 times they played them. But this is also a very different Dallas team after this weekend's loss, mainly due to injury, seeing as how defensive ends Kenyon Coleman and Marcus Spears both suffered knee injuries this weekend. Safety Barry Church injured his quadriceps, and the other starting safety, Gerald Sensabaugh, suffered a calf injury and was seen in a boot after the game. Their status for this weekend's matchup is unknown. Another big question still lingering is the status of Cowboys Pro Bowl defensive tackle Jay Ratliff. Ratliff suffered a high ankle sprain during the Cowboys' final preseason game and has been sidelined ever since. The Cowboys will take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in Big D on Sunday at noon Central Standard Time, 1 p.m. Eastern Time on the Fox Network. And that's all for today's Landry Hat Show, but you can see more of me as a host by heading over to OneMinuteNews.com, or you can click on the links below to follow me on Twitter. Once again, I'm Jennifer Martin. Enjoy the game, and thanks for watching.